لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الصلاة والسلام عليك يا رسول الله وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا حبيب الله الصلاة والسلام عليك يا نبي الله وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا نور الله. My dear Islamic brothers and viewers of Madani channel, we welcome you to our new silsila, Blessings of Bismillah. In this series, we will learn about different virtues of reciting Bismillah Sharif and how one can make a habit of reciting Bismillah before every permissible act. But before, let's hear the virtues of reciting Durood-e-Pak. The beloved of Allah, the knower of unknown, Azza wa Jalla wa sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam has said, "Whoever recites Durood upon me once," meaning salutations and salam, "Allah Azza wa Jal will shower his mercy upon him 10 times. Subhanallah, what great mercy for those who recite Durood, meaning salutation and salam upon the beloved Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam only once. Imagine the extent of mercy on those who recite Durood, send salutation and salam upon the beloved Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam in abundance. Sallu ala al-habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. The ruler of Makkah al-Mukarramah, the master of Madinah al-Munawwara, sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam has said, any important task that has not been started with Bismillah Sharif remains incomplete and unfinished. Dear Islamic brothers and viewers of Madani channel, whenever eating or feeding, serving or drinking, picking up or putting anything back, cooking or washing, reading or teaching, traveling or starting a car, waking up or waking others, sitting or seating others, turning the lights or the fan on, laying or spreading the food mat, folding or preparing the bedding, opening or beginning a business, locking or unlocking, applying oil or perfume, delivering a speech, reciting a naat, wearing shoes, adorning yourself with the Imama Sharif, opening or closing the doors, etc. Always start with Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, unless it is not permissible by Islamic laws, unless there are Shara'i restrictions on it. My dear Islamic brothers and viewers of Madani channel, one who makes a habit of reciting Bismillah Sharif with every permissible act gains immense blessings and virtues. Sayyidina Safwan bin Sulaym rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi says, "Jinn use the belonging and clothes of human beings. Therefore, when whoever picks up an item or clothing to wear or takes it off to put it away, he should recite Bismillah Sharif. The name of Allah Azza wa Jal will act as a seal for it. That means that by reciting Bismillah Sharif, jinns will not use those clothes." Dear Islamic brothers and viewers of Madani channel, similarly, whenever picking up or putting anything back, we should develop a habit of reciting Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Insha'Allah Azza wa Jal, we will be protected from the interference of mischievous jinns. Sallu ala al-Habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. When reading Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, it is important that the letters are stated correctly with correct pronunciation. The level of voice should be such that you're able to hear your own voice, you're able to hear your voice with that if there are no auditory obstructions. Some people either misread or totally miss some alphabets out of haste. To do this purposely, it is prohibited. If the meanings are altered, it will be a sin. People who read incorrectly and imperfectly out of haste should certainly rectify themselves. In situations where the recitation of Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim is not necessary, meaning the entire Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim is not necessary, it is perfectly fine to simply recite Bismillah. Sayyidina Jabir bin Abdullah radiyallahu ta'ala anhu has stated, "When Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim was revealed, clouds moved towards the east, the winds became stationary, the oceans became intense, The creatures prepared themselves to listen carefully. The devils were thrown from the skies. And Allah Azza wa Jal said, I swear by my honor and majesty, anything which has Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim recited upon it, I will put my blessing, I will put my barakah in it. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, my dear Islamic brothers and viewers of Madani channel, is an element of the 30th verse of Surah An-Naml in the 19th part, and a complete verse of a noble Quran. It was sent down as a separation between two chapters. Allah Azza wa Jal has sent 104 revelations and books upon some of the prophets alayhim salam. Out of these, 60 revelations were revealed to Hazrat Sayyidina Shu'ayb alayhim salam, 30 to Hazrat Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam, 10 to Hazrat Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam before the revelation of Torah. There was also the revelation of four major books. The Holy Torah was revealed to Hazrat Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam. The Holy Zabur was revealed to Hazrat Sayyidina Dawood alayhi salam. The Holy Injil was revealed to Hazrat Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam. And the Noble Quran, the Holy Quran, was revealed to the Noble Prophet Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. The summary of all these books and revelations are within the Noble Quran. The subject matter of the entire Quran is within the Surah Fatiha. The entire theme of Surah Fatiha is within the Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. The entire topic of Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim is within the first alphabet, within the first alphabet, Ba, and it implies a translation that whatever there is by me, meaning by Allah Azza wa Jal, and whatever shall be, will be by me, meaning by Allah Azza wa Jal. It is narrated from Hazrat Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Abbas radiyallahu ta'ala anhuma, that the leaders of the Muslim, Sayyidina Uthman ibn Affan radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, humbly inquired about the excellence of Bismillah Sharif from the master of the prophets, the master of both worlds, sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, the beloved of Allah Azza wa Jal, the knower of unknown, the faultless and the perfect prophet, sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, replied, it is one of the great names of Allah Azza wa Jal. It brings a person as near to Allah Azza wa Jal as the black part of an eye to the white part. My dear Islamic brothers and the viewers of Madani channel, there are immense blessings, there are numerous blessings in the Ism-i-Azam, there are immense blessings of Ism-i-Azam. Any supplication, any dua that is performed with the Ism-i-Azam is accepted. The Honorable Father of Ala Hazrat Alayhi Rahma, the leader of the philosophers, Maulana Naqi Ali Khan Alayhi Rahmatul Mannan, says, some scholars have declared Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim as an Ism-i-Azam. It is reported by the master of Baghdad, Sayyidina Ghawth-i-Azam radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, that Bismillah said by an arif, Bismillah said by a devout saint, is like a kun, meaning become, said by the sustainer, said by the Lord Azza wa Jal. My dear Islamic brothers, in order to incorporate the blessings into our valid, lawful and virtuous deeds and actions, we must recite Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. If you desired of developing a habit of reading Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim on every occasion, then make it a habit to travel with the devotees of Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam in the sunnah inspired Madani qafilas of Dawat-e Islami. Alhamdulillah Azza wa Jal. There are numerous examples which manifest the fact that the problems and difficulties of those supplicating while traveling in the Madani qafilas of Dawat-e Islami are resolved. I will attempt to paraphrase a statement of Islamic brother. The Islamic brother says, the bone of my nose was somewhat bent. I also persistently suffered from sore eyes and headaches. I had intended to undergo an operation in Nishtar Medical Hospital situated in Madinatul Awliya, Multan Sharif. Prior to the operation, I was honored to experience the sunnah-filled journey to Pak Patan Sharif in a Madani Qafila with the devotees of Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. I had heard that the supplications and prayers are accepted in the Madani Qafila. I humbly supplicated in the blessed court of Allah Azza wa Jal that, O Allah Azza wa Jal, with the blessings of the Dawat-e-Islami's Madani Qafila, please mend my nose. A few days after returning from the Madani Qafila, something came to my notice. I became overjoyed The supplication performed in the company of the devotees of Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam while traveling in the Madani Qafila of Dawat-e-Islami was accepted. It was obvious right in front of my eyes. The bent bone of my nose had completely straightened and became normal again. My Amir Ahl-e-Sunnah says, Seekhne sunnatein, qafile mein chalo, lootne rahmatein, qafile mein chalo, lene ko barakatein, qafile mein chalo, paao ye rahatein, qafile mein chalo, teri ho haddiyan, hongi seedhi niyan, dard saare mitein, qafile mein chalo, sallu ala al-habib, sallallahu ta'ala ala muhammad, sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. My dear Islamic brothers and viewers of Madani channel, indeed, the supplication of travelers are accepted. Then why shall not the supplication of a traveler, of a person who is a traveler in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah azza wa jal, be accepted? Especially if the supplication is done in the company of the devotees of the noble Rasul sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. The honorable father of Ala Hazrat, the leader of the philosophers, Hazrat Maulana Naqi Ali Khan, says, while mentioning the 23rd respect of acceptance of dua, written inside Ahsanul Du'a on page 57, the supplication that is performed in the presence of learned scholars and pious saints is accepted. In a marginal note, about the particular respect, the Honorable Ala Hazrat Rahmatullahi Ta'ala Alayhi says, about the pious saint and learned scholars, that Allah Azza wa Jalla says in Sahih, authentic Hadith Qudsi, that they are those people that if a person sits with them, he does not remain unfortunate or ill-fated. Yak zamana suhbate ba'awliya. Yak zamana suhbate ba'awliya. Behtar az sab sala ta'ate beriya. Meaning that a moment spent in the company of the honorable saint is better than 100 years of sincere and unostentatious worship. Whether a pious saint is physically alive or resting inside a blessed mausoleum, his proximity and nearness is a reason for the acceptance of supplication. The leaders of millions of Shafi'i, Sayyidina Imam Shafi'i Rahmatullahi Ta'ala Alayhi says, whenever I need something, after performing two units of Salah, I commute to the blessed luminous shrine of Imam-e-Azam, Imam Abu Hanifa radiallahu ta'ala, who and supplicate, Allah Azza wa Jal fulfills my needs. My dear Islamic brothers and viewers of Madani channel, it is known that in the vicinity of the mausoleum and shrines of the honorable saints, supplications are accepted, pleadings are responded to, wishes and desires are fulfilled. The Honorable Ala Hazrat Rahmatullahi Ta'ala Alayh informs us of his incident when he was 21 years of age. He says, on 17th Rabiul Akhir, 1293 Hijri, when I was 21 years old, I was walking with the learned author, the eminent master, the Honorable Master, my dear father, and Hazrat Muhibbur Rasul, the devotee of Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, Mawlana Mawli Muhammad Abdul Qadir Badayuni Damat Barakatumul Aliya. We presented ourselves in the blessed court of a highly revered saint, Mahbub-e-Ilahi, Nizamul Haqq wa Deen, Sultanul Awliya, the king of all saints, radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. Surrounding the blessed shrine, a condemned musical performance and other acts of amusements were taking place. Due to intense noise, we were struggling to hear even our own voices. Both gentlemen entered the Mawajih-i-Aqdas peacefully and became occupied. This faqir, Ala Hazrat refers to himself humbly, that this faqir was being disturbed by the noise and the evilness outside. I stood by the blessed doorsteps and humbly appealed to Hazrat Sultan Awliya that, O Master, the slave is present, but these noises are causing interference and severe disturbance. After this, I recited Bismillah and placed my right foot inside the guest room. With the help of the omnipotent sustainer Azza wa Jal, the noise suddenly stopped. I assumed that the people had abruptly become quiet. When I looked back, I saw the same performance was taking place. As soon as I placed my right foot outside again, I was confronted with the same noise. I then read Bismillah Sharif again and placed my right foot back inside the breast room. Alhamdulillah Azza wa Jal. By the grace of Allah Azza wa Jal, once again, the noise had all of a sudden disappeared. I then knew that this is the benevolence of the Lord Azza wa Jal, Hazrat Sultan al-Awliya's miracle, alayhi rahmah, and that this is the help of the mercy manifested for this worthless slave. I expressed my gratitude and thanks and entered the blessed Mawajihai Akbas, where I remained occupied. During this time, I heard no noise whatsoever. When I left, I was confronted with the same noisy atmosphere. It was difficult to reach the residence situated outside the blessed shrine. The faqih said to himself that this was indeed a ni'mah, the blessing of Allah Azza wa Jal, the Almighty Sustainer has declared. وَأَمَّا بِنِعْمَةِ رَبِّكَ فَحَدِّثْ. Translation from Kanzul Iman. And proclaim profoundly the bounty of your Sustainer Azza wa Jal. This brings great news for the slaves of the blessed saints and griefs for the deniers of saintly miracles. That O Allah, for the sake of your beloved saints, make us prosperous and successful in the worldly life, in the afterlife, in the grave, and at the resurrection with the blessing of your beloved saints. My dear Islami brothers and viewers of Madani channel, this incident happened at the Ba'is Khwaja Ki Chaukhat in Dehli Sharif. From this miracle of the King of Dehli, Hazrat Khwaja Mahbood-e-Ilahi Nizamuddin Awliya, is clearly revealed. Also, this is surely a miracle of my master, my Ala Hadrat Rahmatullahi Ta'ala Alayh, when he placed his right foot inside the room accommodating the luminous grave, he stopped hearing the noise and racket of drums and musical instruments. From this true incident, the advice is clear. If, for example, ignorance and illiterates are displaying anti-religious and unlawful behavior at the blessed mausoleum of the saints, and if you're not able to stop them from performing such unlawful actions, then one should not deprive himself from visiting and paying respect to the shrines of the saints. Certainly, it is religiously wajib, it is religiously necessary that one considers the obscenity displayed as appalling and unacceptable. You must abstain from getting involved. Moreover, you should refrain from looking towards them. Sallu ala al-habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. My dear Islamic brothers and viewers of Madani channel, we're hearing about an incident that took place and how an old man overtook a jinn simply by reciting Bismillah Sharif. Once in the Springfield climate of Masjid-e-Nabawi Sharif, the leaders of Muslim Hazrat Sayyidina Umar Farooq and other honorable companions alayhim ridwan were discussing and conversing about the excellence of noble Quran. During this, Hazrat Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu humbly said, O leaders of Muslim, why are you people forgetting the marvels of Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim? By Allah Azza wa Jal, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim is a very great marvel. The leaders of Muslim, Hazrat Sayyidina Umar Farooq radiallahu ta'ala anhu, sat up straight and responded, please tell us the marvel. Hazrat Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu continued, it was during a famine in the era of ignorance. I was in search of food when I passed by a jungle. From a distance, I caught a sight of a tent. Beside it, I saw a horse and some cattle. When I proceeded, I saw a beautiful lady in the tent's lawn, and an elderly man was sitting propped. I threatened him and said, give me whatever you've got. He replied, O man, if you desire hospitality, then please come. If you want help, then we will help you. I replied, stop making up words and give me whatever you've got. The elderly man managed to stand up like a weak person, recited Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, and came to me and very quickly leapt at me, threw me down violently, sat on my chest and said, speak now, shall I kill you or leave you? I fearfully replied, release me. He got up from my chest. Being egotistical, I told myself, Oh Amr, you're famous horseman of Arabia, being overwhelmed by this weak old man and running away is a cowardly and unmanly act. It is better to die than face disgrace and humility. I got up and once again said to him, give me whatever you've got. Upon hearing this order, the mysteriously elderly man recited, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, and attacked me. In an instant, he threw me down, embarked upon my chest and said, speak, shall I kill you or release you? I replied, please forgive me. He released me. But once again, I demanded his entire possession. He once again read, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, wrestled me and held me down. I pleaded, please release me. But he mercilessly replied, that this is the third time, I shall not release you so easily. After saying this, he called out, oh, go, bring me the sharp-bladed sword. Obeying his command, she quickly presented him the sword with which he cut off my ponytail, off my head, and then released me. Long hair with the ponytail was a customary among our Arabs. If someone's ponytail was cut off, he felt ashamed and humiliated and could not show his face to his family until it grew back. A cut ponytail signifies defeat. Therefore, for an entire year, I was committed to serving this mysterious old man. At the end of that year, he took me to a valley where he read aloud, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. All the birds flew away from their nests. When he read it again, all the animals moved away from their hideouts. When he read it for the third time, a black jinn dressed in woolen clothes about the height of a date tree trunk suddenly appeared. When I saw the jinn, I began shivering and shaking. The old man said, O Amr, show courage. If it overpowers me, you can say the next time my companion will win with the blessings of Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. The mysteriously old man and the black jinn began to fight. They began wrestling. However, the old man lost and the black jinn overpowered him. I exclaimed that this time my companion will win because of Lat and Uzza. This is the name of two idols of the pagans. When the mysterious old man heard me uttering this, he slapped me on my face so hard that even in broad daylight, I began seeing stars. It felt as though my head had separated from my body. I asked for forgiveness. I will never do anything like this ever again. I said in an apologetic tone voice. Later, both of them continued the struggle. This time, the mysterious old man defeated and overpowered the black jinn. Upon this victory, I exclaimed, my companion has won with the blessings of Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. As soon as I said this, the mysterious old man knocked the jinn to the ground like a plank of a wood, sliced open his stomach, pulled out something similar to a lantern, and told me, O Amr, this is deception and disbelief. I asked that mysterious old man, what is the story behind you and this black jinn? He replied, a Christian jinn was my friend. Every year, one jinn from amongst its nation would fight against me head to head. Allah Azza wa Jal would give me victory due to the blessings of Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. We then proceeded along to a place where the mysterious old man fell asleep. I took this opportunity. I snatched his sword and struck his leg so severely that his legs became dismembered from his body. He was screaming and yelling, O betrayer, you have deceived me terribly. I didn't give him a chance to recover. Striking repeatedly, I butchered him. When I returned to the tent, the girl inquired, O Amr, how was the competition with the jinn? I reluctantly replied, the jinn have murdered the old fellow. The girl cried, you are lying, O unfaithful person. The jinns haven't murdered him. You have. She began shedding tears and restlessly read five lines of poetry, which translates, O my eyes, cry abundantly over this brave horseman and shed tears endlessly. O Amr, I commiserate you for your life, although life has pushed your friend towards death. O Amr, now after killing your friend with your own hands, how can you possibly walk proudly in front of your social tribe, Bani Zubaydah, and in front of pagans? I swear by my age and life, O Amr, if you were actually a true fighter, that is, if you would have fought and competed like a man without deceiving and betraying, then this sharp sword would have indeed struck you, would have finished you off. O murderer of the old man, may the true King Allah Azza wa Jal give you a disgraceful and horrible return in exchange of your crime, and may you live a disgraceful and appalling life just as you have treated your friend disgracefully. I fiercely advanced to kill her. Surprisingly, she disappeared from my sight as if the earth had swallowed her. Sallu ala al-habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. My dear Islamic brothers and viewers of Madani channel, so you realize the astonishing blessings of Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. To develop a habit of receiving these blessings, allow yourself the privilege to travel in the Madani qafilas of Dawat-e-Islami in the companionship of the devotees of Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Inshallah, you'll be surprised to see that your problems will be solved with the benevolence, with the fadl and the generosity, the karam of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You will receive unseen help and assistance. My dear Islamic brothers and viewers of Madani channel, a Madani qafila comprising of the devotees of Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam approached a place called Kapalvanj, situated in Gujarat, Hind. During the local area tour for invitation towards goodness, a drunkard confronted them. The lovers of Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam consistently made inspirational individual effort upon him. When he saw the compassion, the love demonstrated by the brothers wearing green turbans, he instantly went along with them. With the blessing of their companionship, he repented from his sins, he grew the blessed beard, adorned himself with the crown of Imam Sharif, and developed a Madani mindset. For 6 days, he had the privilege of traveling in the Madani Qafila, and he made the intention to travel for further 92 days, but didn't have the expense to do so. One day, he met with his relative. When the relative witnessed that one of the society's disreputable person and an alcoholic had actually adorned a beard and a green Imam Sharif and was wearing a Madani outfit, he was baffled. He was informed that all this was due to the blessings of traveling in the Madani qafilas of the Dawat-e-Islami. Inshallah, as soon as the expenses are arranged, he has firmly intended to travel for further 92 days. His relative responded, "Don't worry about the finances. Please accept the expense for the 92 days Madani qafila from me. Moreover, I take responsibility to cover the domestic expenses for up to 92 days. The person then became a traveler on a Madani qafila for 92 days. Sallu ala al-habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. My dear Islamic brothers, we witness, we realize how many blessings there are simply in the traveling in the Madani qafilas of Dawat-e-Islami. Alhamdulillah, Azza wa Jalla, in this episode, we learned how one can make a habit of reciting Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim simply by traveling in the Madani qafila with the devotees of Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. What great blessings and virtues there are of reciting Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. The name of Allah Azza wa Jalla acts as a seal. Simply with reciting Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, the old man overpowered the jinn. Inshallah, Azza wa Jalla, in our next session, in our next episode, we will learn more about Bismillah Sharif. We will learn when reciting Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim is a kufr, when it is not permissible to do so. And inshallah, Azza wa Jalla, as you progress further, we'll learn about more marvels of Dawat-e-Islami. But until then, keep watching Madani channel. Fight against backbiting will continue, inshallah Azza wa Jal. Sallu ala al-habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam.
दावत इस्लामी ने दुनिया भर में धूम मचाई है, दावत इस्लामी ने दुनिया भर में धूम मचाई है, सारे जहां में इश्क मोहम्मद की खुशबू फैलाई है।